The Booth company sales are forecasted to double from 1,000 in 2006 to 2,000 in 2017. Here is December 31st, 2016 balance sheet. Booth's fixed assets were used to only 50% of the capacity during 2016. So we know that the fixed asset can generate a limited number of outputs, so they operate on their capacity. So if we have to increase sales beyond a certain level, then we will require more investment in fixed assets. But currently, the good thing is the company has fixed assets of 500, and their plants are being run at 50% capacity. At 50% capacity, they are producing $1,000 of sales. But in 2017, we will need $2,000 of sales. And if we run this plant at 100%, we can generate that kind of sales by using the same assets. So we don't need to increase any assets to produce a sales of $2,000. We will do it in another way as well, but this is a shortcut to see if we need more investment in the net assets or not. All the assets except fixed assets must increase at the same rate as the sales. So all the other assets must increase with the sales. So if the sales are getting double, then we will need double cash, we will need double account receivable, we will need double inventories, we will also need double accounts payable. There is no information about notes payable. These are not spontaneous liabilities, but accruals are spontaneous liabilities, so accrual will also get doubled. No information about long-term debt and common stock. We have to calculate about retained earning because we will be paying 40% of our income and retaining, we will be paying out 60% of our income to our shareholders, and we will be retaining 40% of our income. So we have to calculate what is this 40% out of our sales. So let's calculate the additional funds requirement. Let's complete this balance sheet first. So here is 2017 balance sheet. So cash gets doubled. Account receivable become 400, inventories will become 400. We don't need to increase our fixed assets. Total assets will be 1500. Accounts payable will become 100, 150. And then accruals will be 100, then 400, then 100. Now we have to think about the retained earning. So our profit margin is 5%. So if we multiply our profit margin with our new sales, we can get the addition into our income, and then we will be paying out some money out of this additional income. So our profit margin is 5%, new sales are 2000, and our payout ratio is 60%. So The $40 will be added to our retained earnings. Our previous retained earning was 250, so new retained earning will be 290. Total will be 1140. So to balance this thing, we would require more funds. So additional funds needed will be the difference of these two, and that is 360. These 360 will be raised either through common stock or debt. It's up to the firm's policy. So there is another way to calculate this next fixed assets. So first of all, we need to check what is our capacity of sales. So we can calculate our capacity by dividing sales with capacity usage. So our current sales are 1000 and we are using only 50% capacity. It means with the current capacity we can generate 2000 of sales. So we can utilize only our current capacity to generate 2017 sales. Next is our target fixed asset or sales ratio. Our fixed assets are currently at 500 and our future sales will be 2000, so our ratio will be 25. So for this ratio, how much fixed asset would be required? We multiply this ratio with our sales and we get 500. So we require only $500 of fixed assets to generate a sales of 2000, because we already have these 500 of assets. So we will just carry forward to next year. We don't need any additional investment into our fixed assets.